The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Nice to see you all again. In the last class, we have discussed about conjunctions, right?
Yes.
Have you read the content? Yes? Very good. Children, you should read the content, okay? Then only you will understand it, okay?
Yes.
So today, let's learn about proper nouns, common nouns, and also about possessive nouns. Okay,
yes.
Before that, let's recollect what are nouns. Do you remember? Yes? If so, say it loudly.
Yes.
The names of people, places, things, or?
Yes.
Objects are called as nouns, isn't it?
Yes.
So today, we are going to learn proper nouns, possessive nouns, and also about common nouns. Okay?
Yes.
So, first of all, let us discuss about proper nouns. Okay?
Yes.
So, take page number 91 in your studio. Possessive nouns. Recall that nouns are names of people, places, animals and objects. We have already said that nouns are the names of places, people, things or objects. Proper nouns name specific people, places, things or ideas. For example, Ashok, Delhi. So proper nouns name specific people. Specific people, specific place or things. Okay. So, proper nouns are used to name particular people, particular person, particular place or particular thing or a specific object. Okay.
Yes.
For example, Ashok, Delhi. So, we can say examples such as Swadhi or Amala, then Alex or Alathur, then yes, Palakkad. Okay, these all are proper nouns. Is it clear for you?
Yes.
It names a particular place or a specific place or a specific person or a specific idea or a specific thing. Okay.
Yes.
Since these nouns name specific things, they always begin with a capital letter. Since these nouns are used to name a specific thing or a particular thing or a particular person or a particular object or person or thing or a place, they always begin with capital letter. Okay. They will always begin with capital letter. So, a proper noun. They are used to name a particular place, particular person, or a particular idea, or a particular thing. So, these proper nouns always begin with capital letter. Okay.
Yes.
Now, common nouns. Common nouns are general names of people, places, things, or ideas. So common nouns are the general names of people, places, things or ideas. Whereas the proper nouns name a particular person, particular place or a particular object. Okay, yes. Example for common nouns, man, city. Okay, man and city are general names. Okay, so they are example for common nouns. Okay, yes. Since they do not name anything specific, they don't need to start with a capital letter unless they begin a sentence. So these are need not to be started with capital letter because they are not used to specific name or a specific place or a specific object. They are used as a general name. So they don't begin with capital letter unless they begin a sentence. Whereas the proper nouns should start with capital letter because they are used to name specific people, specific place, etc. Is it clear for you? Yes. Color the words denoting proper nouns in blue and those denoting common nouns in yellow. Okay, so there is a simple activity. They have given some words there. So you should color the words denoting proper nouns in blue color. Okay, and those denoting common nouns in yellow color. Okay, so you should do it individually. Okay, yes. Next, your teacher will read out some sentences in class. Take a quick poll. Fill in the blanks with the classmate's name as suitable. So there are some sentences and you have to fill in the blanks with a classmate's name. Okay, you can write any one of your classmates or any one of your friend, etc. Okay, so you have to write the name of your friend there. For example, Dash's birthday is in July. So Swadhi's birthday is in July. Likewise, you have to do this activity. Okay. So while doing that activity, you might have noticed this punctuation mark, isn't it? Yes. And this punctuation mark is called as apostrophe. Okay. What is it? Yes, apostrophe. And when we add the letter S, okay, when we add the letter S to this apostrophe, it is called apostrophe S. Okay, apostrophe S. Okay, so observe the apostrophe S in the sentences in look around 4.8. This, when added to a noun, indicates ownership or belonging. So this apostrophe S, this is used to indicate ownership or belonging. This is used to indicate ownership or belonging. Okay, yes. Such nouns are called possessive nouns. Okay, such nouns are called possessive nouns. The nouns that are used to indicate belonging or ownership. Okay, they are called as possessive nouns. Okay. Now look into that activity. Dad's birthday is in July. Swadhi's birthday is in July. So whose birthday is in July? Yes, it is Swadhi's birthday is in July. So the apostrophe S indicates the belonging or the ownership. Okay. Yes. When apostrophe is added to a noun, it indicates ownership or belonging. Such nouns are called possessive nouns. For example, you may have said, Priya's shoes are black in color. Whose shoes are black in color? Yes, it is Priya's shoes are black in color. This indicates that the shoes being referred to belong to Priya. So the shoes referred here belong to Priya. Possessive nouns show a relationship of belonging between one thing and another. So possessive nouns shows a relationship of belonging or ownership. Okay, so possessive nouns show a relationship of belonging or ownership between one thing to another. The punctuation mark apostrophe. The punctuation mark apostrophe is used to indicate this belonging or ownership. So the punctuation mark apostrophe indicates that this belonging or ownership. Okay. Yes. To form the possessive of a singular noun, we add apostrophe plus s to the noun. To form the possessive of a singular noun, we add apostrophe plus s to the noun. Okay. To illustrate the example in look around 4.8, Priya plus apostrophe s plus shoes equals Priya's shoes. Okay. Priya plus apostrophe s. Priya plus apostrophe s equals to Priya's shoes. The shoes belongs to Priya. Okay. So the apostrophe s indicates the ownership or belonging. Okay. Yes. Here are a few more examples. Fill in two of your own. So here are few more examples. So you have to find out two more examples and you should fill the provided space. Okay. Yes. So today we discussed about proper nouns, common nouns, and also about possessive nouns. Okay. What are proper nouns? Yes, the nouns that are the names of, specific names of a place, a person, a thing, or an idea. That is called proper noun. Example, Ashok, Delhi, Meera, Palakkad, Alathur, etc. Okay, yes. What are called common nouns? Yes, common nouns are general names of people or things, objects or place. For example, man, bird, etc. So that is the difference between common noun and a proper noun. And then we discussed about possessive nouns. Okay, possessive nouns are the nouns that are used to indicate belonging or the ownership. Okay, so possessive nouns are used to indicate the relationship of belonging or ownership between one thing to another. Okay, yes. So here we use the punctuation mark apostrophe plus the letter s, okay, to indicate the belonging or the ownership of a particular thing. Okay, yes. So I hope all of you understood about proper nouns, common nouns, and also about possessive nouns, isn't it? Yes. So read the content very well and do your home funds. Okay, so see you in the next class. Till then, bye.